It's been a huge year in Power Platform and Dynamics 365. This is my top 10 in 10 review of the highlights of things that were delivered or delivered in preview this year. There's a heap of other stuff that was announced. We'll get to that next year, no doubt. Here's what we were delighted by and able to start working with in 2021 that I think is the most important. Now I agonized over what I was going to put at number one versus number two. These two, honestly, super, super close call. Here's what I've gone with. Dynamics 365 Teams Embedded Chat. The reason I've got this at number one is because this is the biggest thing that's going to change for us in business applications next year is collaboration and business applications and the way they work together. And this is the first stage in that. So I really wanted to put this one up front. You can now have Teams down the side here as a chat panel embedded in Dynamics 365, full chat experience. And this is really putting collaboration at the forefront of business applications. Absolutely watch this space. I mean, literally watch this space. I'm going to be posting a heap of stuff. Subscribe if you want to know more in the new year there. At number two, and like really, this is a massively important platform direction as well, is the convergence of model-driven apps and Canvas apps. This piece of custom pages in model-driven apps really gives us that first landmark on that convergence roadmap. And again, there's going to be lots more coming here. So what we can do now is create a custom page for a model-driven app or for Dynamics 365 using those PowerFX Canvas app skills, which means you can create like a landing page, bring other data sources in there, have a pixel perfect design landing page for your users inside your model driven app. That's a big one and plenty more to come there as well. At number three, we have customer journey orchestration. And I've put this one up because it's more than just marketing. So this is all about being able to do real time, event based, moments based marketing. We start with a trigger right in the moment when someone does something. They land on your website and click through. They place an order. They connect to your Wi-Fi. So these can be things outside of Dynamics 365 that are triggering those events. What we're going to see into 2022, it was announced this year but hasn't landed yet, is being able to trigger Power Automate flows out of this as well. So big direction here, real-time marketing, but this is more than just marketing. This is journey orchestration across the whole thing. At number four, PowerFX for model-driven apps. And there are two things in here. First one here is the ability to do commanding without needing code. So the ribbon that's at the top of your model-driven app where you can press a button to make something happen, we always had to use code or external tools to be able to work with that. Now we can use PowerFX to do this. And so PowerFX is a name that was announced this year for all of this stuff. We're starting to see this flow through in lots of different parts of the platform. So as a general trend from 2021, that is a super big deal as well. And the other part of this is the introduction of being able to use PowerFX formulas in Dataverse calculated columns now. This stage only available for Dataverse for Teams, but it has flagged that this will be coming to the full Dataverse, so something to look forward to. At number five, we have Microsoft 365 and Dataverse search integration. This is a big deal because this is the kind of thing that we get exclusively working with Microsoft technologies. This is not something that our competitors are going to be able to offer. So when you go in and search for something, at the moment you're searching across all of your Microsoft 365 resources, you can search documents and things like that. This is an example now of what will happen in Teams chat with this federated search experience. We're putting in here the name of the country and it's bringing up documents as well as customers with that name. So we're searching across Dataverse data and unstructured Microsoft 365 data all in the one place. Being able to find things quickly and easily with a quick search is a really, really important part of productivity and a good user experience. So this seems like a little thing, but this is quite a big deal. At number six, this is a huge thing that is definitely a big deal. We have industry solutions, industry clouds. We saw the Microsoft Cloud for Nonprofit and the Microsoft Cloud for Financial Services go generally available in November this year. We've also got clouds for manufacturing, healthcare, retail, and also the announcement of the Microsoft Cloud for Sustainability. What's going on here? This is the definition around the digital transformation platform. This is bigger than just what we know as business applications. This is, of course, Dynamics 365 and Power Platform, but also Microsoft 365, Azure, LinkedIn, bringing all of those pieces together to create things that are industry-specific solutions pre-built in components, and customers can take those and work with them as they wish different stages and build on them. So this gives us a really, really good way to work with industry solutions without having to start from scratch every time. Really also helps put this stuff on the map against our competitors. So massively important space. At number seven here, we have the Deal Manager, which is sitting inside Dynamics 365. Now, why would a dashboard, like a single dashboard, make my top 10 for the year? This is not a Dynamics dashboard as we know it, right? The standard dashboards in Dynamics have always been sort of basic charts and things. This one allows you to click on a chart. So the bubble diagram in the middle there is showing you the likelihood of your opportunity closing and the size of the value of the opportunity. And as you click on each one, so you're doing it in that visual representation, on the side, inline editing, where you can go in and edit your opportunity details, add tasks and so on, click back on the bubble diagram, edit the next one. So from somebody working through a pipeline in this experience, you don't have to start with a view and click away or search and click away. You're actually working the whole thing from this single view with this inline editing experience. I think this is really amazing user experience for sellers and sales managers in Dynamics 365. Absolutely cut above anything we've seen in the dashboarding there before. Hope we get to see more of this kind of thing in the future. Number eight, this is a licensing thing. Licensing makes the top 10. Isn't that an awesome situation? Power Apps Pay As You Go plan. This is something that people have been wanting. I've heard people say it's too good to be true. Essentially, this allows you to get started with Power Apps without having to buy those licenses, the per user or per app license. It's billed through your Azure subscription, which means you can bypass the procurement process. You don't have to commit upfront to, you know, buying all of those licenses. And importantly, you're only paying for active users. So this is great if you've got a massive employee group, massive user base, but they only log in infrequently. Say you've got an HR app where people log their leave. They all need access to it, but they might only use it once, twice, three times a year. So you're only paying per active user, per app, per month. So that gives us a whole extra awesome entry point for getting started with Power Apps. At number nine, we have granular data loss prevention. Two aspects here, and this is sitting sort of, you know, right deep down under the hood. But we have the ability to block certain connectors in the Power Platform, but this gives us the ability now to block certain actions rather than having to block the whole connector. So Twitter is a great example here. A lot of organizations would just go, I don't want people to be able to use apps or flows to post tweets. So I'm gonna block that whole connector. Whereas now you can see here, we can do something where we can just block the posting action, but allow the other actions of getting followers and getting information and getting the Twitter feed to be there. And the other one we have here is the endpoint filtering control. Again, things like the HTTP connector can be a bit dangerous. People would just go, no, we'll block the whole thing. This allows you to just choose which endpoints are allowed or specific ones that are denied, rather than having to block that whole connector entirely, because it actually is a really awesomely useful connector. So granular controls giving us a heap more options there. And last but certainly not least, number 10. This one's at the end because this is the very start of something that's going to be huge as well. Power Apps Maker Collaboration. Forever, one of the top questions has been, can two people build a Canvas app at the same time? And the answer's been no. Now we've got almost. So what we've got here first up is the ability to have commenting. So you can comment on that the same way you would with any kind of development situation. This is also available in Power Automate. And experimental feature, but this is the future state, and hopefully by this time next year I'll be talking about this a lot, the ability for two people to co-edit at the same time. So at the moment it's doing a bit of a sync and it's an experimental feature, but certainly on the roadmap, the ability to be able to properly co-edit. So there we have it, my 2021 top 10 in 10 for the year. Thanks everyone for watching and for supporting me this year. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll be back with another one of these for the Wave 1 release, probably late January, early February, whenever we get access to that. And as always, thanks for watching.